Okay, so today we are going to learn about some drawing tools here and some modify tools here. So just look at this. We have some more tools over there. If I click on this drop-down arrow there, and you can pin this all the time if you are working with this drawing tools. Most of the time, so you can pin over there. Here we have this construction line option and ray line options. So these two line is used for creating your plan. You can use this option. So let's go for construction line options. Use. So this line is a infinite line, okay? And how you can create? You have to specify a point, and that is your source, and then you have to specify a through point. Okay? You are specifying through point that will direct the infinite direction. So you are specifying one through point, and opposite that also it's going infinite like this, and from that source it will continue creating a line, creating a infinite line or x line. If you keep mentioning the through point, you can have more line, more x line, or else you can go for escape. So you can go through this icon over there, or else you can type XL, x line or construction line. You start a point and then you specify a through point over there. So if you need a straight line, straight infinite line, activate your ortho mode. Okay, and then escape. And now creating your plan, you can use offset, right? So for that, let me check the unit. Give some values over there. So this is insertion scale. This is not my drawing unit. This is insertion scale unit. Okay. And for drawing unit, we have command dash DWG. And here you can see that drawing unit. This is your drawing unit, and that is 1 inches. Right now it's set as inches. Here you can see. So for millimeter or centimeter, you have to type. So F2, if you press F2 to see that AutoCAD text window, here you can see again that 3 is the option for millimeter, 4 is the option for centimeter, 6 for meter. So here, let me move for machine, enter, and display format to decimal. That is okay. Display format, it's done. Display precision to digit, okay. And scale objects from other drawing upon insert, absolutely yes. And do you want to match insertion unit to drawing units? Yes, I want. And scale objects in current drawings to reflect change in units. That is, you can do yes, and even here, if you go for no, so that will not make any sense as because we haven't done in other unit. So now I have set my drawing units. Now let's go for the value, and here I will. specify offset results. Okay. For this. And another says because this dynamic input is on, I can change it. Now for this wall thickness, we go for so it will be very easy if I go for this construction line. If I go with this construction line and then I offset and then and like this, you can continue creating all the diagram over there, and then after that you can trim all the unnecessary part and you can have it. So this one, let me complete this. You can have now we also have one option that is called ray. You can use this option also. So this option will have only in a single direction. This will have infinite length only in one direction. So I will specify a source that is my start point, and from this source it will start creating infinite line, and I'll mention a point through which it will pass. So that is the point, and there it is the point. Okay. So it was I had used this with construction line, right? Even after this also, you can keep these lines for creating your elevations from this. I can use this as your projection line for creating your elevations from your plan, that you can keep these lines. So that is your ray line there. I'll give you one plan. You can create your plan. I'll give you the task. And guys, if you can access the chat box here, please write your email address. I'll send you there. I will add you within the Microsoft team there. I'll be sharing, so you can share your email address in WhatsApp or else within this chat box. Please start sharing your email address now. Now let me go for and we have some other options like creating spline fit and spline CB. So this is smooth polyline. Spline is your smooth polyline, and you have two way to create spline, that is spline fit and spline CB. So let's go for that spline fit. So I'm just specifying some points there. you can deactivate your auto mode, and now you can close for it. And if you select this there, just you see that you have this points within this point, this spline is fit. You can change, you can control this spline with this points. So this this spline is controlled by this point now, and surrounding this points, this spline is fit, and you can change it to control vertices. That is your CV. You can change it to control vertices. So there will be some vertices, and with this you can control. So this has some degrees to control this curve. So you can control better with this control vertices option. You can again make it fit like this. So let me this. Now let me go for a rectangle there. Now just focus on this spline fit. I'm going to specify these four points, and then for this I will close. Here you see, and now what I do, I'll go for spline CB there. So this will be my first point, this will be second, this will be third, this will be fourth, this will be, and then close it. Now let me delete this rectangle. Now you can see that we have one spline that is created by spline CB and one that is created by spline PD. So you see that these are your vertices points for this, and this is your fit points for this splines. You can change it, it will be like that. Here you have. So with this you can create your topo surface, you can create your contour lines there. Yes. Okay. Now let me show you that how you can create your ellipse. We have two ways to create ellipse there, center and axis N. So you know that ellipse has two axes. One will be your major axis, one will be minor axis. According to the value, it will, this AutoCAD will decide which one will be the major, which one will be the minor. So let's go for center method here we have. Or else if you type with the command, that is EL is for ellipse. And if you go for command, the by default option will be axis end. So here you can see in this command line window, we have option for center and arcs. So that is for elliptical arc. We will come on that later. Here you have this option center. So if you want to go with center option, then you have to specify here. If you go for command. Okay. So let's specify the point that will be the center for this ellipse. And then you have to define one endpoint of your first axis that depends upon the value, that it will be major or minor. And then after that, you have to define another endpoint of your axis. As because you are going from center, so from the whole axis you just have to define one single point of your axis. So let me define particle bottom mode on, and here let me define this. Okay, and if the next axis first input point is greater than the previous one, that will be the major axis, and if it is lesser than that will be minor axis. Okay, so you can decide. So I have given with my mouse pointer, you can give exact value there, so let me keep that like and here let me 50. Okay. And again let me go for axis end point now. So now you see that I can track this one snap point from here. Track it. All right. So here let me track like 50. I'll start from here, and then I have to define another point of this same axis, as because I'm going with this axis endpoint. So the first axis, for the first axis, I have to define two points for the first axis, and after that for the another axis I just have to specify one single point of that axis. So let's specify like 1000, and then here I will specify 250, and here we have. Okay, so we know how to create a ellipse with this center and axis endpoint. And now let's create elliptical arc. So for elliptical arc, you have to create a ellipse first, and then you will define the angle for your arc. Okay. So for creating an ellipse, you can either go with this axis endpoint, either you can go with the center. So the center method is bit easy, because you just have to specify one single point for each axis. So let's go with that center. Then this one will be the center, and then you define the first endpoint of your axis. So let me go at 130 there, enter, and let's go for 4. Okay, now you define the start angle and the end. So let me specify this will be the start angle, and there it will be the end angle. Okay, so that I have created one elliptical arc. Let me create another elliptical arc here. So here let me go with this. like 175. Enter. Sorry. Then you have to specify center, otherwise it will take access input. So that is the center, and then there let me go for 175 there, and then next go for 300. Then you will specify the start and end. So let me specify this would be the start angle and this will be the end angle. Just see that I am specifying the start angle and the end angle in the anti-clockwise direction. That you should do also. That is the positive angle direction. So after specifying this as a start angle, I'm not going to specify this as an end angle. So it will create confusion. So it will always, even if I go for this in this direction, in this clockwise direction, it will create in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so if I need results like this, so I'll go for anti-clockwise direction, and here it is done. Okay, now let me select this and this, and after that I'll go for rotate. And I will go for this as a base point. And after that, I will go for copy. And then I will give the value 180 degree. First, specify copy. Now, rotation will give the rotation of angle. And that is done. And now, let me go for fillet there. And let's go for radius. So now see one thing, that I'm going to trim this line with this line, and it's giving me the fillet smoothly. I don't have any problem. I have one problem, that is I'm not getting another segment of this line, and for this line also. So for that, what should I do? If I go going with the stream, and I have created this whole single line for this, then what should I do? Either what I can do is either go for break at point, select this, break at this point, again go for break at point, select this and break at point, and then you go for fillet there. Radius 50, enter, select this and select this. Either you can go like this, you can go for it. Or else what you should do is, while creating this fillet, before mentioning your radius value, specify no trim option. It will not trim. It will create the fillet, but it will not trim. So that you can go with without breaking your lines. And the radius is already specified. So we will create multiple fillets with the same radius, like four times. So let's go with this multiple and then start. Just give me a second. Okay, so select this and then this one, select this and this one, select this and this one. Okay, and after that, trim it. Alright, so we have done. This ellipse and elliptical arc. I can fill this hatch with this hatch and gradient option available. So I can fill some pattern with this hatch over there. So now see this pattern is selected, and I'm going to fill within this point. it's asking me to specify points, because by default this pick point option is selected. You can go with this select, so you can select one object, and in between the area of that selected object the pattern will be filled up. So we can select this and it will be like that, and after that you can make it transparent as well. You can make it transparent. So right now I don't require to fill within the whole ellipse. I will change that later. Let me just change this pattern over there. See, I'm changing the pattern, but it is not visible. So why? What should I do after that? My desired pattern is not visible. Even if I apply hatch for this, the right pattern. So you have this scale option. You need to match this scale with your drawing, so that here you can check it. So I think this one right, so here you can correct, so you can give the right hatch pattern scale what you require, and according to that you will get it. Okay, now I want to remove it, so I will select this object ellipse and it is removed. Okay, and now again I can go for pick point, and there I can specify this like this. Okay, and here you see that I have specified two hatch within a single hatch command, but I need these as a separate, this one as a separate hatch, this one as a separate hatch. So if I close this, I will get it as a separate hatch. Why? Because within this option, this was selected as a separate hatch while I was creating. Let me show you again this hatch, or you can write command H enter, and here you see within this option this create separate hatch option is selected. If you uncheck this, if you uncheck and then you go for this like this, two separate area within a single hatch command you are defining, then you will see that this is a single hatch, right? So if you need results like that, make sure you specify create separate hatch. Okay, now here you see that we have some more patterns, like concrete patterns are there. So you can use all the patterns available here. So you just need to open this list. Okay, you have all this, and you can change the list from pattern to gradient. So all the gradients will be available. But within all the lists, you can have access for all of them. So you are just sorting the first option, like what you want, solid color, gradient. Okay. Then about the gradient, that is combination of two colors. That is first color is blue and second is selected yellow. Let me change that. And here you see that this pattern is selected, and that pattern is placed at the center to the placed, it will be placed at the center of your hatch region. Okay, so let me not make it transparent. So here you can go for center. Okay, and here you see. And if you don't go for the center, and that pattern will not be placed at the center of that region. Okay, so what is your requirement? As per that, you will specify. Now we have another option that is called associative. So what is associative? It will be associated with that boundary. So if you later change the hatch boundary, the hatch will be updated. So always go with this associative. If you need changes later, so we can go with this associative. And we have another option that is annotative, that is controlled by annotation scales. So we have this annotation scale. We can create some annotative objects, and we can control with annotation scales there. So all the annotative objects will maintain one scale that you can go with this. So let's go with that. So let's create this separate hashes over there, and here we have. Okay. Now again, let me go for hash, hinter hash, and then let me go with this gradient value. Center, and now see that it's going to fill in this. So I need to fill within this region, within this quarter of this 1/4 region of this ellipse. I want to place it here. So for that, what I should do is here to keep go for this options. Now you see that it's it is selected this outer island detection. So it will, here you see that this one is the outer island within this area. So it's filling like this, right? Now if I go for this normal island detection, and as per the point, it's asking me now for the application. And we go for no island detection. So as for the pick point, in this it's selecting this one, in this it's selecting. So let me that level. And for the pattern, no, sorry, gradient over here. And now let me go this select object, and then let me go for normal island detection, and select this object here. Okay. So this is not the right example to show you. We go for the hatch, then we go with this normal island detection, and we go for this big point. over here. Hatch. This normal identification. Yeah, so I hope you can understand this, right? Now let me do this here. Okay. Now let me go for this hatch. Now if I go for this outer island detection, so this is your outer island. And if you go for normal island, so all the islands would be selected. Suppose you generate this as a sea, so this would be your island and this would be your island. And now again, let me go for this normal island detection. And now you click on it, so this one is your island, you see. So after this outer island, it will not select. After that, it will miss out, and then it will fill up the region, and then in between that it will also not fill up. Let me again go for hatch, and this normal island and this outer island is there, and you can ignore the island detection, so it will fill up like this. It will not detect any island, it will fill that whole region. Okay. And there is the no island detection, is kind of similar. Okay. It will do like same. So it will not detect any island there. You cannot means within this whole region there shouldn't be any island there. You cannot place there with this option. So you can only place there, and within this region, there is no island. So that is the option. I hope I can clear it. And we have some array of option. We have some array option there. So in the last class I have already discussed about what is array. So about the direction, on the base of direction we have three different type of array. First is rectangular, then path, and then polar. Rectangular, you can create your specified number of items in a specified gap within x and y direction and z direction as well. And path array, when you don't have any specific direction, then you will go for path array. And when you have a circular direction, 360 direction, then you will choose polar array. Okay, so let me go with this rectangular array and let me select this and then enter. So from this object center, by default you will have some numbers there for columns, and between in between space you will have some numbers, and it will go in the positive direction. You can change this with this grid points as well, like this. You can change this. Let me go with this. And here you see that I can again click on any of this object, and then I can change. So if I need to change or edit the array after that, so what I should do is I should go for associative. I make all the duplicate objects as a single object as under this array. So here you can give column numbers, how many column is there. So level is in the Z direction, you can also create. So here you can specify level and between space. Control in between numbers there, okay. Let me go for three. Okay. So this is your base point. You can change the base point as well, like this. So that will be nothing, like whenever you close, this will be the base point, and with this point you can easily move. You can easily move it. So that's why it is needed. And from this base point, you can change this column numbers, and you can increase your column numbers with the distance, and you can change this distance, and this is for your column numbers. You can increase or decrease, okay, with this grid points as well. You can change it only after that, only you will get this option after creating your array if you go with the associative option. If you don't make it associative, those will be as individual object. Those will be as an individual object, and later AutoCAD cannot identify that these objects were created by array or you have just created normally. Okay, and if you need to make them individual again, so you can do that also. So for that we have explode option X enter. It's a command, and right now they are at their freedom. All the objects are individual right now. Okay, so I hope up to this is clear for everyone. And this is the end of today's class.